Welcome to the session of Master Stroke. And this Master Stroke, we are going to discuss about the DI or data interpretation. And data interpretation is very specifically, we are going to discuss about tools for DI. Tools for DI, it is your second challenge. First challenge is how to classify the DI caselet. That already we have seen in one of the Master Stroke. This is your second Master Stroke related to your how to handle the DI caselet. How to handle the DI caselet? We have to take care of two challenges. First challenge is how to classify, categorize the DI caselet. Second is tools for each and every type of DI caselet. Then this is applicable for all type of DI caselet. And of course, it is going to improve your DILR section. Then without delay, just we'll try to understand what are the tools and how to develop the tools, mathematical tools or maybe logical tools. The second challenge is DI, tools for solving any types of DI. How to approach? These two factors will be there, means tools we have to develop to solve any type of DI caselet. Like once you categorize, this caselet is based on the type 5. Then for type 5, which type of tools you are able to use. Second, how to approach for a particular question, means from which point we should try to analyze the data. That is one of the important thing. How it will come? It will come based on your the sense of data handling. Once you are reading the tables, graphs and plots, during reading time, you can improve your response and reaction time. How you will able to improve your response and reaction time? Because you will able to understand the limitations of the questions. Means based on this data, this type of question can be, this type of question cannot be, this type of question going away from the CAT syllabus or aptitude level of questions. Means these type of question only will be possible. Once you are able to understand your understanding level is going up to that level, then what you will guess or what you will understand, these are the maybe 5 or 6 type of probable questions are there. You will find almost 50-60% questions are coming down from that probable list only. Means you understood, okay, these 6 type can be, more than that is not possible. Then how to approach, it will depends on your sense of data handling and how much you are gaining the confidence during reading the data. Means data, if it is given either in the form of tables, graphs or maybe diagrams, or maybe it is given based on any of the mathematical concept also, then this is going to improve your accuracy and of course it is going to reduce your time. Now thus few other points just we'll discuss related to tools. As per the challenges, that is classification of DI caselet, total 8 type of caselet that already we have seen in another Master Stroke. Now this Master Stroke we are going to discuss how to approach any particular type of DI caselet. Means out of T1 to T8, just suppose any of the caselet you have taken or any of the caselet you are going through, you found this is T3, this is based on the type 3, then how to handle, means which type of tools you should use. Simple tool, either it may be mathematical tools or maybe logical tools. Every type of DI caselet, hardly 15 to 20 tools will be defined, and these 15 to 20 tools will give the limitations of question asked for any particular type. How much crux information I am just providing to you. Means every type of DI caselet, whatever we will categorize from T1 to T8, hardly 15 to 20 type of tools will be defined. Don't think it is some books or some writer has defined. Just I am making these tools, this list of tools that will be applicable for particular type of DI caselet. Okay, this is not academic preparation, this is competitive preparation. Then we are also putting so many cleverness, like question setter are putting cleverness, we are also putting the cleverness. We are also just we are becoming more clever how to handle the and how to read the mind of question setter. Then these 15 to 20 tools will be sufficient to solve any level of question related to that particular type of, you can say this will give you the limitations, more than that it will not be there. Few tools may be common to more than one type of DI caselet. Don't think every type of DI caselet all tools will be totally peculiar or totally new. No, many of the tools will be common, like for type 1, type 2, type 3, maybe type 4. Few of the tools will be always common, like percentage calculation, comparison of ratio. These all you can see it is a common tool. These are all the common tool. But just you are coming very specific tool, like number patterns, based on the number patterns or arrangement of the numbers, then only it will be used for your T5 type of DI caselet, like games and tournament, where number pattern or based on the arrangement of numbers, many of the questions used to come. Then how to make one number in different type of pattern or different type of arrangement. Like 15, we can write 15, we can write 5 into 3. We can write 5 into 3, there is no problem. Or 3 into 5, both are the odd number. If 3 into 5 we are writing, then we can write it in the form of sum of consecutive natural number also. We can write in the form of the factor also. We can write in the form of summation also. Means so many type of so many type of number pattern, or you can say representation of number, we will write one single number that will be used for your T5 of DI caselet, that is games and tournament based. Just I'm telling a specific tool and general tool. Then few tools may be common to more than one type of DI caselet, like percentage, ratio. After then RD technique again common, means you can say remainder divisor technique. If this is basically, it is a converting tool, conversion. Means once one data we are converting from one category to another category, like if you want to convert any absolute number into percentage, or again percentage to decimal, or again decimal to absolute number or ratio, then these RD technique will be helpful. Then just will come little bit about the very particular tool which are listed out in type 1, like T1 type of DI caselet. This is based on the tables, graphs, plots and diagram. What are the tools can be if DI is based on type 1 or based on the tables, graphs, plots and diagram? Factor multiplication, that is one of the most important tool, or you can keep as a first tool that will be very frequently used. Second is your conversion of number, or you can say it will be used for RD technique. Next is higher power calculation. Next is percentage of percentage change. And next most important tool is how to calculate CAGR, SAGR and AAGR. Like that, 15 to 20 tools for type 1 DI caselet is there. If you want to learn all these tools and how to apply all these tools, then continue to learn at the rate of parolico.com, or you can download the mobile app also. Thank you.